Hey guys, how are you?
Hey, we're fine. How are you?
Good. Good to see you guys again. It's been a while.
Yeah, it's been a while.
You guys look exactly the same.
I take that as a compliment.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you look like you aged a little bit.
What can you do? I probably look less tired, you know?
Yeah. I mean, how's school?
Less ragged, less torn apart by tour, so.
Yeah. How's school?
School's good. Second semester was much better than first, so we'll just leave it at that. School went fine.
How's life on campus now after the tour? You a celebrity?
You know, it's pretty much back to normal now. I was I kind of came back on a little bit of a bender, but figured it out. So now I'm back to school, back to the grind. Just serving tables for the summer. So. And I'll finish here. So
you need to come out to a show soon too. We're missing you.
Yes, dudes. Yes, yes. I would love to. That would be awesome. Let's do it.
Send us your schedule so we know when you're working, so we can pull you out of work.
Dude,
pull you out of work.
I will. Like, and I can request off whenever you need to. So just, you know, pick a city, pick a place, and I'll be there. So.
So you missed the bunks on the bus.
Oh my god. Yeah, the bunks, well, you guys had me in the bottom one, eventually, which was right above the generator, so, I don't think I missed that bunk too much, but,
strategic move from our side.
Yeah. It was cool sleeping right underneath you, Stefan. It was cool. That was part was hearing you roll around as we rumble across the country, so, yeah, but,
So from this, I mean, from the whole week, what was the best part, do you think? What was the funniest moment?
Funniest moment? I don't know. I think the thing I liked most about being on tour was just, like, getting to, like, live your life for a little bit, see the world through your shoes, or, like, walk in your shoes, see the world from your perspective. It was pretty cool just to kind of be on vacation and, you know, be automatically a cool kid hanging out with you guys, you know?
Would you be up for doing it one more time if we?
Yeah, name the time and place, and I'll be there.
We do the sequel,
dude. I'll come on tour with you guys all year. Just like, I can't wait to get back to Dada Land, man. Please.
Do you still have your banana suit?
What did you
think when we made you wear it all the time?
Well, I mean, once you guys gave it to me, I kind of expected it to be on pretty much all.
And it was.
Yeah. I wore the same one in New York on New Year's Eve. In New York. So, yeah, that was crazy. But smells terrible. I washed it like 3 times when I got home, and it's just fucking reeking.
The good part is your clothes smell fine. It's the banana suit that takes all the damage.
Takes the blame.
Yeah.
Should we check into these? You know, we have some questions that we have... people post on Facebook. They have stuff they want to know from you.
Cool.
We have some printed out here. Should we start checking them out?
Sure. Yeah.
You ready? You're in interrogation mode? Okay. Jerry McMullen asked, did you think Dada Life were arrogant towards you?
Arrogant? No, not at all. Maybe it was a little bit awkward at the very beginning, but, you know.
It was a little
like a happy thing. No, not at all. No. No way.
Nice. John Jameson Murphy wants to know how many bananas were consumed overall?
Hundreds, not thousands. I mean, like, we took like 5 crates of bananas into the woods to do some of those scenes. I mean, there were bananas everywhere. No one had a problem with bananas. They were all over the place. So.
And you're probably allergic to bananas now.
I certainly ate enough bananas on tour to last me for the rest of the year. So.
Callum Matheson is asking,
yeah, okay.
What were you attempting to do when you managed to stop the music in Boston?
No.
Oh, God. I was not attempting to stop the music. I was really hammered that night.
And
I was dancing around like I normally did on stage, and I was right behind the DJ booth. And You know, like my hand hit some buttons, and I was like holding my camera with one hand, and I don't know. I only sort of remember that part of the evening. I like remember like this guy grabbing me and like fighting him off and trying to stage dive, and like like the crowd just like rejected me and was like, "Fuck you, dude." I like fell into like the pit between the stage and the people, and I had this huge bruise on my side, and I was running. I don't know. And Toby was yelling at me. He said I was going to get kicked off tour, and I mean, there was only one day left at that point. But yeah. You guys weren't too bad, were you? I mean, like,
we're fine.
Yeah, it was lame. But
David's question is, what city raged the hardest?
The hardest. You know, Toronto was pretty crazy. That was Sound Academy. That one was that was pretty awesome. And it was my first show too, so maybe I'm biased, but
yeah,
Toronto
was
pretty
amazing. That was fun.
Right? It was that one blew my mind. So yeah.
Okay, now here's a good question. Boyan is asking, how did you survive?
It's harder to survive real life than tour. You know, a tour, you have all the food you want, all the booze you want, you know, all the ladies you want. I mean, there's everything. I would rather be on tour. It was easier. Get to sit around all day and relax and then go and have a raging party at night and then sleep and repeat. I mean, you guys had the best life. I had a great time, so...
Ben Mills wants to know, did you even finish your homework?
No, not that semester. Next one I did. I did much better in the spring, you guys. You gotta forget fall semester.
You were ruined for a bit of time after the tour.
Yeah, that homework didn't quite get finished, no. So.
Okay, what about this one? Christian Kasevsky is asking, you'll definitely miss the whole Dada life, the whole Dada team. What or who will you miss the most? Now that's an important question.
Toby?
Okay, see, I'm gonna go.
I'm such a family, you know. I mean, I hung out with you guys, but I got to know so many wonderful people. I mean, Kevlar, Jade, you know, Jace, Toby, you know, everybody. It was so fun. Magnus, I miss Magnus, and no one snores like him. You know? So,
like being a part of our dysfunctional family there.
It wasn't that dysfunctional. A little bit. It got, you know, there were stressful moments, but it wasn't. It was a pretty loving, supportive family. You know, I mean, people passed out those jelly bean like vitamins. The gummy vitamins every day, you know, there was...
That's what kept you alive.
Yeah, that emergency and Red Bull, sure.
Okay, Matthias Juno's question is, did they give you the opportunity to take a closer look at their productions, or was it just, like, top secret?
Well, I mean, I got to, like, see what was going on backstage, and, like, I got to watch you guys remix some songs sometimes, but... But I mean, I don't really know anything about music production, so like, you know, you can only watch someone pressing buttons, listening to their headphones for so long before you want to do something else. So, but yeah, I mean, I got to like listen to some songs that you guys were working on. You guys were working on the Gangnam Style remix on tour when I was there, so that was fun. But yeah, I didn't really like learn any secrets that I could like give away or something, you know.
Bad for you.
You know.
Billy Johnson asked, what was your favorite experience overall?
Probably, you know, the coolest thing on tour was just getting your perspective at those concerts, you know, watching the strobes flash on 3,000 people dancing in front of you, like all screaming up at you. Like, I mean, there's nothing better. It was great. That was the coolest moment, was definitely being on stage, fist pumping right next to you guys. So
this one, I think we actually answered. Diego Orkis wants to know, how bad does your banana suit smell?
Oh, fucking terrible! disgusting. But I
you know you can't wash it. You know that.
You what?
You can't wash it.
I did. I watched it when I got home twice.
That's true. I remember you watched it even in the sink.
Yeah, I don't think the smell of champagne is ever leaving. So.
Yeah, champagne. Talking about champagne, we have one question. Last question from Ben Silver.
Okay.
He's asking Nolan, what do you think the champagne that Dada Life kept spraying on you symbolized? I have my own theory, but I would like to hear your thoughts.
You know, it's kind of like you just use champagne instead of taking a shower on tour. You know, there weren't showers for like 2 days, so like you gotta wash off. You know, spritz yourself with some cologne. You know, as well use champagne. So yeah.
Close to the truth.
Yeah, close to the truth. So,
cool. I think that was all the questions we have. I mean, like, thank you for taking the time again. Next time we see you, it's gonna be on tour, right?
What?
Next time we see you, it's gonna be on tour.
Yes. Please bring me out. It'll be awesome.
Yeah. So the next mail from us will be: we're gonna fly you to a show. And you're gonna rage, as you've never done before.
It's fucking
in your smelly banana suit.
Yes. We want you to wear the banana suit.
I'll bring the banana
suit. Your place on the plane, the whole ride.
I'll wear the banana suit. I'll do whatever. So
awesome.
It'll be awesome.
Cool.
So, yeah.
Cool. See you then.
All right.
Bye-bye.
See you guys. See ya.